My name is Justin Smiley, and I am 34, soon to be 35. So this coming open, I get to check the master's box for the first time. And I am very happily married to my beautiful wife, Jackie. And we have three little girls, 7, 5, and 2, Layla, Hazel, and Eden.
How long have you been doing CrossFit?
So I had to think about this the other day, and I just renewed my CrossFit Level 1 Trainer certification, and that's every 5 years, so just a little over 5 years.
And what is your favorite movement in CrossFit?
I knew this one was coming too. I really like handstand stuff. So handstand push-ups, handstand walking, being upside down. I feel like that's a decent movement for me, and when it's a good movement for me, I like it when it shows up in workouts.
How about least favorite movement?
Probably the opposite of Grant Jarzynka, which would be anything with a heavy barbell. It's not that I dislike heavy lifting or heavy barbells, but I'm just not as good at cycling a heavy barbell. So if they were like, all right, man, you got to do like some AMRAP with squat cleans at 225, like Justin's going to have some issues.
Do you believe CrossFit is for everybody?
No. And I think that can kind of be like a tricky question and how it's asked and how you answer it. I think anyone can do CrossFit, but CrossFit is not for everybody. And that may not come across as like a huge selling point for our box, but I think it's the truth. I think anybody, regardless of age, experience, physical ability, can do CrossFit, but CrossFit is not necessarily for everyone. Some people are going to be into other sports, extracurricular activities like sand volleyball or golf. Everybody has their thing, and even though I believe everyone can do CrossFit, I also have to recognize and be honest with myself and say it's just not for everybody.
Why do you enjoy coaching CrossFit?
As a coach, I think one thing we deal with on a daily basis is, yes, we're selling CrossFit, but we're also selling ourselves. So it can be tough sometimes when, you know, you're trying to give somebody a cue or instruct them in a certain way and they don't get it or they don't understand. And it's not necessarily like they're trying to attack you as a person, but I'm in my head, I'm like, oh man, I'm not good enough, or I can't, for whatever reason, I can't say what I'm trying to get them to do, or maybe they're not hearing it, or I'm not putting it in the right words. But when you have that moment as a coach where you conquer that and you kind of overcome that obstacle, it's just a huge victory. And I love getting to see like the reaction in my athletes' eyes when I say something and they understand.
So why Share the Burden CrossFit? What makes Share the Burden different than other CrossFit boxes?
I think in most CrossFit boxes that you go to, I mean, they're going to emphasize community. Like that, I kind of consider CrossFit and community synonymous. You don't really have CrossFit without community. People would ask all the time, like, what's the difference between CrossFit and high-intensity interval training or HIIT training? Like, there's really not that much difference. I mean, that's basically what we do. The vast majority of our workouts are high-intensity interval training. But what makes us different is our community. And I really believe that. And I think you could probably go to a lot of boxes and they might say that community matters. But I see that every day in our coaches, and I see that every day in our athletes, that we're not so much concerned with what the scoreboard says or what the clock says or how much weight you lift. Just that you're pushing yourself to your own relative intensity, and then most importantly, you're kind of rallying the troops and encouraging everyone to help each other.
Which classes do you coach?
So I typically coach Monday evenings, in Fridays and Saturdays. So if you come in Friday evening or Saturday morning, you will have me as your lucky coach.
What does Justin's diet look like?
Lots of healthy meats, tons of veggies. I would probably say on the high end of fat, so like high fat, moderate protein, and low carbohydrates.
So what's Justin's favorite cheat food?
Cheat food, that's super hard. I would have to say butter cake with chocolate frosting. And then maybe a little bit less cheat meal would be tart cherry pie, but with stevia for sweetening, because then I can eat